The reality is you fail at whatever pace you're failing, and you have to try and pull something from it as you do it. What I learned from that failure is, if I can't save this, what can I possibly save out of this? And what I determined was that there were assets there that I might be able to liquidate and at least give the investors some type of return on their investment. As I was leaving what was a miserable experience and changed really my empathy and my relationship to what it's like to run a startup, because it was the first one that I had been in that was bad, I was pulled aside by one of the board members, and he said, I just did this huge deal with Dell and HP for these burn drives, and there's a little company down in LA that's a content company, and if that company dies, my drive deal is going to blow up, and it's worth a lot of money. Would you consider flying down to LA and doing what you just did here? And I was able to sell that company. So once again, now I'm in a failure, but I'm trying to do something that's slightly better than auctioning it off for parts. And that time I was able to get a different return out of the investment. And so that launched a whole phase of my career while I was doing turnarounds. I will say another important thing that I learned from failure is that even in failure and incredibly stressful situations like that, you can learn a lot about the quality of the team you've built or the character of the individuals who you've hired, and you should file that information away because it will make you smarter about how you hire the next time. You should also still look for how you're going to build relationships. For example, when I was shutting down the set-top box company, there was a $250 million balloon payment that originally had been written to a small movie company that had subsequently been acquired by Blockbuster. When I asked the board why they would ever do a deal like that, and the board included some really impressive, important venture capitalists, the answer was, well, we figured by now it would either be a huge success or it would be dead and it wouldn't matter either way. But the point was, the company, the movie company that had been acquired by Blockbuster, Blockbuster was kind of on thin ice at that point as well. Blockbuster's CFO started calling me every day and saying, where is my $250 million? At first, I tried to push the calls off to my CFO, and that only worked for a couple of weeks. And then I started talking to this guy. Eventually, I negotiated him down to $30,000 in cash and some free content encoding for their digital service, because that was really all I had to offer. But the important lesson was, when I jumped into that next company, I sold it to Blockbuster, because I had built a relationship with that man. He got to know me, he knew that I would give him the straight scoop even in a situation like that. And so even if your house is on fire, don't just look at what you can save, look at who you can save, and look at opportunities for what you can take with you to the next new house.